Welcome to JSA TV, the newsroom for tech and telecom professionals. I'm Jamie Scott-Ukitaya. Here in beautiful Honolulu, take a look at this video shot from a drone, care of X-Site Modula of PTC'19. Joining me here today in fabulous Hawaii, my good friend, Mr. Raul Martinek. He is the CEO of DataBank. Raul, welcome to JSA TV.
Thank you very much, Jamie. Thanks for inviting me.
Oh, our pleasure. And DataBank has certainly been in the headlines lately. A lot of expansion going on. Correct. Tell us a little bit about it.
Sure. So, 2018, we spent actually a lot of time just on organic expansion. We built four new data centers in our existing markets. We had done four acquisitions in 2017, so it was kind of like following on those initial investments in those markets. At the end of the year, we made a new announcement around an acquisition of a business called Lightbound, which is in Indianapolis, and it's a kind of a typical playbook out of DataBank's playbook, which is, you know, an attractive secondary market, a leader in that space from a colocation and managed services perspective. So we think it fits in really nicely with the rest of the portfolio.
And that's a brilliant lead into my next question, really. You have a big focus on these edge markets, so tell us a little bit more about this approach.
Sure. Yeah, that was, back in 2016 when DigitalBridge acquired the business, that was really the thesis that we came up with, which is we saw that there was a lot of, a lot of inventory, a lot of existing entrants in the tier one markets, but that there was less competition, less high quality inventory in the secondary market. So when we acquired DataBank, you know, it started in Dallas, but they had decided to expand to Minneapolis and Kansas City, and we've kind of continued that trend going into markets like Salt Lake, Cleveland, Pittsburgh, Baltimore, Atlanta, which is probably the closest thing to a tier one market, and now Indianapolis. So our particular view is that the edge is going to emerge first in these secondary tertiary markets, or, you know, second tier NFL markets, and then we'll expand from there. So we think we're really well positioned with that geography to capture that trend.
And we're certainly hearing a lot here at PTC, actually, about the benefits of bringing the eyeballs closer to the content.
Correct.
and just in terms of quality of service, latency, reduced latency, et cetera. So you're seeing all that. You're giving those benefits on to your clients.
Yeah, obviously that's a solution for kind of the top, call it 20 cloud and content OTT guys. Mm-hmm. There's obviously a lot of local enterprise demand in these markets, and that's a key component of our demand profile. But there's no doubt that, from a distribution, IP distribution perspective, these larger players are beginning and have deployed nodes in these markets. And we think that will, at some point, get to kind of more availability zones or more compute and storage nodes, but those days aren't here yet.
Yeah. And what are you seeing in terms of your customers' hybrid cloud strategies? How is that going?
Yeah, that's another, thanks for that question. And that we made an acquisition at the end of 2017, a company in Baltimore called Edge Hosting, which really had an advanced kind of managed services stack. So we think that hybrid approach is a real dynamic in the enterprise space. And we see probably, call it 30 to 40% of our enterprise deals where that is a key component of us winning the deal. There's still plenty of kind of enterprise deals that happen just purely co-location, but more and more CIOs, CTOs are embracing kind of a service provider that can kind of do more than just space and power.
And when we're talking, looking out towards the future, it's the beginning of 2019, I know 5G,
sure,
a hot topic here at PTC 2019. What are the predictions that you may have for 5G?
So 5G, obviously, topic, very, very topic du jour. As part of the DigitalBridge portfolio of businesses, you know, we have the benefit of kind of having sister companies in VerticalBridge, which is a U.S. tower REIT, in Extenet, which is a small cell provider in the U.S., and Vantage, which is a hyperscale player. So we have a rather unique 360-degree view in the space. Obviously, we do business with those large mobile operators, especially on the tower side. And we think 5G is it's completely happening. It's starting to occur, but we don't really think 2019 is when it's really going to kind of hit critical mass. It's probably more a 2020 or even a 2021. But certainly there's a lot of focus on it, a lot of investment, and it's going to be a good thing for the sector.
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. I couldn't agree more. And so what are we going to see from DataBank in 2019?
Well, I think you'll see a lot more of the same. We hope to make a new announcement shortly about another acquisition, and we'll just continue to kind of keep our head down and build organically to meet the demand that we see in the markets. I mean, we think it's a two-punch, type of strategy, and we just are trying to, become, the number one or number two provider in each of the markets that we operate.
Yeah, well, exciting. DataBank for sure, an organic and inorganic growth story. One company to watch, and it's databank.com.
That's correct.
So for viewers who want to learn more, go ahead and check out databank.com. Raul, always a pleasure. Thank you for joining us.
And thank you very much.
And thank you, viewers, for tuning in to JSA TV. Happy networking.